Hello and welcome. Thank you so much for watching. This show is all about giving you insights and showcasing brands that help you to live your best life and give you confidence. As always, I want to kickstart your morning with some motivational advice to help you to feel inspired and energized to start your day. Today, I want to talk about the importance of making your mental health a priority. Have you ever seen a hamster run on a hamster wheel? They keep running frantically in a never-ending cycle. Similarly, with the hustle and bustle of life, we fall into the same pattern of living in a rat race, repeating the same patterns and routines without putting much focus on our mental health, making it our number one priority. The truth is, our minds and the quality of our thoughts dictate the quality of our lives and how we experience life. By making our mental health a priority and by taking care of ourselves and taking time to do things we love, we restore our happiness levels, leading to a more productive and happier life. One of my favorite ways of working on my mental health is meditation. Meditation quiets the mind and oftentimes gives me the clarity I need after a hectic day. This clarity and peace that meditation gives me allows me to be a better person in my job and relationships. When we don't take time for our mental health and make it a priority, we and the people around us pay the price by having to deal with irritable behavior. Managing stress with healthy habits like meditation, reading, and self-care is vital in living a fulfilling life. As Steve Maraboli quotes, "It's up to you to start making healthy choices. Not choices that are just healthy for your body, but choices that are healthy for your mind."
Stay tuned. Coming up after the break,
I want to talk about your latest invention, the SitFit chair, because most of America, North America, everyone's sitting, especially right now with COVID, everyone's sitting down for hours and hours. So I think your invention is really going to help people. So let's talk about the SitFit chair.
8 years ago, it struck me that the number one killer, the number one cause of pain and suffering, the number one healthcare cost is not something people would guess. It's sedentary disease or sitting disease.
Next up on the show, we have Dr. Zvi Pearlstein. Dr. Zvi is the inventor of the SitFit chair, equipped with a total body gym that helps you to get fit while you sit. Dr. Zvi, thank you so much for being on the show today. How are you doing?
Doing great. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. So let's just dive into it. I want to talk a little bit about your background. You practice general orthopedic surgery in the US Air Force, and you've practiced for over 25 years. Let's talk a little bit about your background as a doctor.
So I got into orthopedics dealing with pain. I was trying to figure out what to do in medicine. Once I got to medical school, you've got a lot of problems that people have that they bring upon themselves. And mm-hmm. So if you're going to help them and they're going to do the same habits that cause the problem, it's not too rewarding. When mm-hmm. I found out about orthopedics and piecing people back together from aging problems or sports injuries or accidents, it was very rewarding because they needed your help. They wanted to be better. And it didn't mean they necessarily had to change their own behavior, like with drinking or cigarettes or eating habits, things mm-hmm. like this. So I got into orthopedics. It was very rewarding. Ortho means straight. Pedics is children. How do you help a child grow physically straight?
Wow, very interesting. And you've been described as the soul doctor. So let's talk about that and how you heal the soul.
Well, my mother was a Holocaust survivor. Okay. And I think I'm dealing with pain from the womb. I absorbed her pain. And, you know, we think of pain maybe injury to the body or problems with the body and aging, arthritis, etc. But pain is also a soul thing, non-physical pain. Pain we experience from our life experiences, changes, stresses. And as an orthopedic surgeon, for example, there's trauma, piecing somebody back together from a plane or helicopter crash, from M16 wounds, things like this. But also, if somebody has low back pain, is that pain related to their father having cancer, to their child being born with all kinds of problems they have to deal with, to not having financial ability to handle things they need to handle in life? Pain can be of many sources. I'm also a musician. I play trumpet since I'm 8 years old. And being a musician, it brings a sensitivity. Soul and body. You've got music has a lot to do with souls. Music is called the pen of the soul. Mm-hmm. So dealing with the whole person. We're soul entities, non-physical entities residing in a body which very often becomes the entire life of the person. But the soul really is who we are, and the body is simply the vehicle to allow the soul to pursue its mission. This is soul medicine, to be able to deal with all of it. Mm-hmm.
And I like that you have a spiritual approach to medicine and being a doctor, because as you said, it's connected. The mind, body, soul is all connected, and it definitely all affects each other. So I like that you have that approach. I want to talk about your latest invention, the SitFit chair, because most of America, North America, everyone's sitting, especially right now with COVID, everyone's sitting down for hours and hours. So I think your invention is really going to help people. So let's talk about the SitFit chair.
8 years ago, it struck me that the number one killer, the number one cause of pain and suffering, the number one healthcare cost is not something people would guess. It's sedentary disease or sitting disease. Sitting disease consists of a collection of epidemic diseases: obesity, low back pain, heart disease, hypertension, diabetes, many cancers, many depressions, and muscle, tendon, bone, and joint ailments that come on with aging. How do we defeat all this? Well, it struck me that for thousands of years, we're sitting in chairs. You know, we used a horse to travel, and we came up with a car. We were IBM, we came up with Apple. We've been in chairs, sitting, sedentary. I came up with SitFit chair, which is, I believe, the first non-sedentary or active chair. It's a total body gym. You don't need the gym anymore. A total body gym in a fold-up portable backpack or wheeling chair, which is multi-positional, upright and reclining, and it goes everywhere, and it's multifunctional. You can sit in it, do your computer work, you can eat in it, you can sleep in it, get a massage in it. Wow. Many different functions, but you can take 5 minutes, 10 minutes, do your abs, do your low back. And abs and low back core is not lying down. You're doing it sitting up like a mensch. It's a super device, and you have unlimited incrementally adjustable resistance for both abs and low back, as well as arm and leg extremities.
Mm-hmm. And how many hours is considered unhealthy when you're sitting down? Because obviously some people can't help it working in offices or, you know, due to their job. So how many hours is considered unhealthy, and how many hours would you recommend on the SitFit chair to get fit and, you know, kind of work the body?
So let me skirt around that question and say, how many cigarettes or how many drinks or how many drugs is going to put you in a category of affecting your health? We know that when we smoke, drink, drugs, we are potentially causing a problem with our health. Mm-hmm. Sitting, people sit all day, eating breakfast, sitting in a car to get to work, to sit at a desk all day, sit for lunch, sit in the car, sit. I don't know that we know this exactly. There have been a lot of studies, but we know the more you sit without moving, it's not about sitting or standing, it's about moving. So mm-hmm. to be able to be in your chair and do motion exercise activities, you have healthy fluid motion through the core with SitFit chair, and you have all the exercises you can do basically in a gym, other than an advanced aerobic program. The more time you spend active, that you're not overdoing it, causing problems. For example, you're going to go running miles and you're going to hurt your joints. That becomes an issue. But to be able to be in your chair, SitFit chair, and do all the exercises repetitively through the day, we can certainly generate studies in time where, with a medical school or a science program, figure out how much you need to do each hour or in each half day, let's say, to become non-sedentary. Mm-hmm. Because currently, every human being on the planet, no matter how much activity or how much exercise, every human being leads that ubiquitous sedentary lifestyle. That's what we want to overcome.
Yeah, I completely agree. And I do think with COVID, it's become worse. People are sitting down for triple the hours because they're watching TV, they can't go anywhere. And I really think the SitFit chair can definitely help with that. I know you mentioned some of the functions, but let's talk about a couple more so that people know what they get into with using this chair. What are some exercises they can do other than crunches?
Well, the most important part of the device is the core exercise, which is that's going to govern your weight and weight loss. That's going to govern your back pain. These are the two biggest things. We have worldwide obesity epidemics in adults and kids. That's a whole nother question. Why and what's the solution to that? I don't think the $80 billion weight loss business in America has the solution. I think they have temporary solutions. But this chair is a solution. It's part of your lifestyle. You have then the low back exercises, range of motion and strengthening. You have all the arm exercises. You have biceps, you have triceps, you have deltoids, you have lats, you have traps, press, military press. You also have legs, you have quadriceps, hamstrings, hip abductor and adductor. You have glutes. You can use it like a bicycle, and basically with the lower extremity component, you can bicycle with the chair. And you can have 2 to 3 people working out at one time because somebody could be sitting. Then you also have biceps and triceps you can do standing up, and you have leg exercises that you can do and arm exercise you can do standing up. So it becomes not just a chair, but a mini gym. If you had it at the beach with a group of people, it's multifunctional with a number of different people. It comes in 7 different colors, so it can be personalized. You have a family of 5, your family of 7. You can each have a different color.
Amazing. Let's talk about how do you think your background as a medical professional has helped in the design and creating the SitFit chair?
So I'll give you a simple example. Yesterday I did some video of a woman who was brought to me as a social media influencer. The day she was introduced to me, she was on her bike and was hit by a car and broke her ankle.
Wow.
She's scheduled for surgery. I helped her out, got her comfortable, changed her support she was in. And what do you do if you're in a cast or a splint, you have a broken leg or arm? You're gonna go to the gym. And by the way, you mentioned the virus, the pandemic. Gyms have been closed or problems. People are sheltered home. Some countries, Israel, Germany, England, have been locked down. Where are you going to go? What are you going to do for exercise? SitFit chair is amazing for that. Take me back to where we were.
Your medical background, how do you think medical it's played background. In the design of the SitFit chair?
So, for example, when I filmed her with her fracture, the chair, the foot is higher than the knee, is higher than the hip. Most chairs or your couch, if you're going to lie, in order to get the foot elevated, you got to put pillows. If you go in beach chairs or lounge chairs, the foot, the knee, the hip, the foot is level or lower. Here, the foot is higher, so swelling can go downhill back into the body. That's one thing that comes from a medical background. The other thing is the whole idea for this comes because of my orthopedic background and dealing with people with problems and trying to find solutions. This is one of a whole collection of products, solutions, books, inventions I came up with in the 30 years that I've been involved with orthopedics. And thinking out of the box, because the solutions we have, orthopedics takes you to surgery, but there are many non-surgical solutions that I've come up with. That's why I call the company Missing Links Health, because every time I came up with an idea from my orthopedic background to make things better for people, a better solution, and probably a better cost as well, because you're talking about trying to avoid surgical treatment when possible. Surgery, orthopedic surgery is looking towards surgery. I'm looking for a solution to the same problems that's non-surgical. And that's what we have in most part. It's a prevention. And very often that means just say no. There are things we do, we have to be very careful because the problems come when we make a choice It gets us into a situation that we wish never got into, whether it's an accident, whether it's a sports injury, whether it's doing too much, whether it's saying no to smoking, to drugs, to excessive alcohol or alcohol altogether. It's the saying no that puts you in a place. It's saying yes to things that are healthy and positive in your life and saying no to the things that will lead you astray. And all these solutions that we have in Missing Links Health, SitFit Chair, is a positive solution to prevent problems, to maintain, to prevent the problems, and to recover from problems. Because what you're going to need with any muscle, ligament, joint problem is motion to recover. Mm-hmm. And SitFit Chair helps promote that.
Yeah. Prevention is definitely key. And as you said, staying active, moving the body. Let's talk about, you know, your background, because you obviously have a wealth of knowledge. I know you also write books. So let's talk about some of the different books that you've put out there.
So I actually penned a book from 95 to 98 that isn't in print yet. I'm working with an editor. It's called Silent Sacrifices. It actually gives all the stories of how I came up to certain solutions to many problems. Those solutions and problems are presented in a book that just came out. It's in Amazon and wherever soft cover and e-books can be found. It's called capital letter U, capital letter R. You are not what capital letter U eat. You are not what you eat. A doctor's guide to transform your pain to pearls of wisdom and joy. And what this book is a guide. It is the solutions I found for the pain that my mother had, for my own pain I absorbed from her and my own problems in my life as an orthopedic surgeon dealing with thousands of patients, both in the Air Force as well as civilian life in many different locations all around the world. I think what I present there is solutions, and you are not what you eat. Solutions to people's problems, whether it's weight reduction, whether it's addiction and recovery, whether it's pain management, whether it's aging gracefully, whether it's what do you need for fitness? What do you really need? Do you need to be in a gym? Do you need to do an hour of yoga, Pilates, Zumba, Tai Chi? What do you need? So that's all in there. Then I have a book that was back in 2006 to 8, I put out called The 1 Minute Stretch. It's a head-to-toe four-inch motion routine. This doesn't exist anywhere in the way I packaged it. It was a book DVD, then I turned it into an ebook, and it comes with videos, and it teaches you how to move with wisdom from head-to-toe four-inch motion, because you have your neck for your whole life. What do you do for your neck every day? You do something for your glasses, your watch, your cell phone, your car, your home, your refrigerator, your all the machines and technologies. What do you do for your neck? What do you do for your shoulders, your elbows, wrists, your hands, your low back, hips, knees, ankles, feet? At the very minimum, you should move these muscle joint groupings through full range of motion every day, at least once a day. Because if you don't, the muscles and ligaments will shorten, stiffen, tighten to the point of maximum motion. Pilates, Tai Chi, Zumba, what did I leave out? Yoga. They're great. If you're going to be sedentary, they're better than sedentary. But if you have the ability to choose what you're going to do with your time, and your time is precious, the 1 minute stretch gives you total body, full range of motion, something, it's a course, something you can learn and do very simply. I believe everybody needs it. From the time they get a toothbrush at the age of two, the only health education really little kids get is a toothbrush. From the time they get the toothbrush to learn the 1 minute stretch and practice it at least once a day for their life, we would eliminate billions of dollars of musculoskeletal costs in healthcare. So these are the books. Then I have a 40 video package online called Stretching for Pain Relief, which teaches you a lot of things that you need to know everybody needs to know in terms of muscle and joint health, how to stay healthy, how to avoid pain. If you get pain, whether it's from aging, whether it's from injury, whether it's from being sedentary, what do you do? What are your questions? What are the answers? What does it mean to go to the doctor? Why do you need the doctor? What's he going to do? What should you ask him? What is x-rays all about? What's MRI all about? And it gives you a place then to start, because we don't have that education. People don't have that education. Aside from getting a toothbrush at the age of 2 to 3 that every little kid gets, when do you learn back, neck, shoulder, knee, etc.? when you have a problem at 50, 60, 70, and it's too late. Because then you're going to be pushed into a mode of treatment that you know nothing about. You're going to think it's what you need. The doctors are nice. They're there to help you. But you do have options. Very often, you really don't know what they are. You are not what you eat. Gives you a better understanding where those options are, and my other packages as well. Mm-hmm.
I love that you have a core solution to most of the problems that people have with pain and being unhealthy, and as you said, being sedentary. So I love that you have these solutions. Let's talk about how people can purchase the SitFit chair and as well as your books.
So SitFit chair, the simplest way to see us is to go to Sit, S-I-T, Fit, F-I-T, like fitness, chair, C-H-A-I-R, sitfitchair.com. Mm-hmm. And you can find out about the chair there. There's a 1 minute video that's spectacular. And you click on to purchase, it'll take you to the Kickstarter campaign. In Kickstarter.com, if you go to Kickstarter.com, where we're currently running a Kickstarter, successful Kickstarter, you can purchase the chair. The chair is selling way underpriced at $100 right now. You buy this chair, which really should be $9.99 or so. But for $100, you buy the chair. If you go to Kickstarter.com and search SitFit chair, it'll come up and you can purchase a chair there. SitFitChair.com. Come visit us.
Thank you so much, Dr. Pearlstein, for being on the show today. This segment has been very insightful, and I wish you continued success.
Hey, listen, I can play the trumpet now. Thanks very much, Sarah. Appreciate your enthusiasm, your joy, your high level of spirit.
Oh, thank you so much.
And your obvious beauty.
Oh, thank you so much. Tag TV is available on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Apple and Android TVs, as well as on Apple and Android phones. Watch us live through YouTube and Facebook.